There are many ways that diseases can spread. We still have a lot to learn about how CWD spreads, but we know some methods. Infected animals shed prions, the cause of CWD, in several ways, such as in saliva, urine, feces, semen, and antler velvet. As soon as a few months after exposure, infected deer start shedding prions and continue to do so for as long as the deer lives, usually 18 to 24 months after infection. Prions can be spread through contact between individuals, such as during mutual grooming within family or buck bachelor groups, or from interactions during the breeding season, or dispersal of young males, which may spread prions among different groups of deer. Human activities like feeding, baiting, and providing mineral licks cause deer to congregate, which may lead to contact between groups of deer that wouldn't otherwise interact and may increase the risk of prion exposure. Fawns may be exposed to CWD from their mothers while they are still in the womb. Prions shed by infected deer can build up in the surrounding area. When infected deer die, the prions inside their bodies also enter the soil or water. Uninfected deer may then be exposed to the prions in the environment, which can remain infective for years. However, CWD can spread even further and faster when people move entire deer carcasses, high-risk parts like heads, brains, and spinal cords, or live deer from an infected area into a new location. CWD can spread in many possible ways, including social interactions between deer, natural deer movements, an artificial congregation of deer, contamination of the environment with prions, and human movement of deer and deer carcasses. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more videos on CWD and deer.